Hello and welcome to another video. So in this video, we are going to show you how to upload files so that your website can be seen. Now, if you have just bought hosting, the most likely thing is that you're going to see a page that looks like this. And this page is usually provided by your hosting provider as a placeholder, a placeholder that allows you to show that your website is actually loading, but should be replaced with your website. So the first thing that you need to do is first log into your CPanel. Now, the CPanel details have been sent to you on email by your hosting provider, and you should be able to find them with instructions on how to log in. And once you log in, you should find an interface that looks something close to this. You may find some older interfaces of CPanel, but they basically have the same functionality, just that this looks a bit more new. Now, once you get here, you need to go to your file manager. The file manager is the way in which you control all your files within your hosting space. So that's email files, that's basically everything to do with your website. Now, once you get here, you would need to click the public underscore HTML folder. Now, this folder is shown by the globe icon. And within this folder, all websites load within this folder. If you place your website outside of this folder, it very likely is not going to load. However, there are cases that it can load, but it would not load automatically. That if you do your domain.com or .co.ke, it would not load if you've not placed your files on the public underscore HTML. Now, you double click on the public underscore HTML and you'll find files that are already there. Now, these files are the ones that allow for this site to be seen as it is right now. Now, the first thing we are going to do is first we are going to take all the files, select all of them by clicking the first one, pressing the shift button and going to the last one. It will have selected all of them. Now, it's not advisable to delete files on the internet, so it's not a good habit. So the first thing we're going to do is compress. Now, by compressing, we are backing up the website as it was into a format that will not interfere with the new website we're going to bring in. Now, notice that this zip file here is the one that is shown as assets. So we'll need to replace, so that you can remember what it was called, just click once, then pause for a minute, then click again, and it should allow you to edit the file name it backup. Now, since I already have a backup file, I'll name it backup 2, so that they don't conflict, and then press enter. Now, once you've done that, you should click on the first one as you did again, then shift, then go to the very last one. But since you want to preserve your backup, you need to press the control button and click to exclude the backup file that you'd selected. Now, after you do this, press the delete button and it will delete all the selected files. Now, remember not to click the skip to trash because it will permanently delete the files. You may need them later on and it's good to have them as a backup. Now, once you've done that, you'll only remain with the backup zip file that you've zipped up, and now you're ready to upload your site. Now, in this state, if we try to reload our website again, you will notice that it shows this ugly interface. That's because we've deleted all the website files from the public underscore HTML. Now, once you're ready to do this, now the next thing you need to do is upload your website. Now, before you upload your website files, if you have a template somewhere that you've gotten from the internet, or whatever it is you're getting your template from, you need to zip it. So the first thing you need to do is to go to where you've stored your files. In this case, mine is on the templates, and here it is. So mine is, I've chosen a HTML5 up template, and you'll notice that this is a zipped file from this particular files. And how you zip all your files is by selecting all of them, again clicking on the first one, then shift and clicking on the last one, then saying send to compressed zip folder, and it will create your zip for you as it has done here. So once you've done that, you'd go. So you click on the upload. Once you've zipped it, click on the upload. It will take you to a new tab that will say select the file you want to upload, and this will show the public_HTML. Now this is important. Remember, you need to upload your website to the public_HTML for it to load when somebody visits your website from wherever in the internet. So select, you'd select the files. And remember, our zipped website is, I named mine as website.zip. Now, once you do that, it's going to upload, and you need to wait until the bar goes green. In this state, if you close this window at this point, it would abort the installation, the upload, and it would you would not be successful. Now, you need to wait for it to go to completely green, and once it goes completely green, then you can be able to close this window. Even when it's 100, don't close it until it turns green, because it will show that it has been completely installed and accurately uploaded. Now that it's green, there you go, you can close that. And you notice that it's not shown. The files that you uploaded are not shown on this on the public_HTML yet. That's because it doesn't auto-refresh. So when you refresh, you'll notice that your website.zip, remember that one? There it is. So what you do, what you need to do is right click on this, and you would do extract. Now by extracting it, will extract it to the public_HTML, and there we go, extracted. And there we go, wonderful. So if you looked at, you went back, you remember the ugly screen? Right now it should not be an ugly screen again, because we have uploaded the template, and there we go. You have a beautiful template uploaded. And if you had already developed the site off-site, then you can, there's nothing you need to do. If you'd like to edit your files, you can actually edit them on cPanel itself. And the way to do this, now remember, the index file is the one that is called when calling the homepage. So when you do, like for instance, my domain name, cialfuatu.com, it would direct straight to, it would go and look for the index file. And so if you want to edit your homepage, you'd right click on the index, then click edit. And once you do edit, it will open a new tab that shows, allows you to edit your HTML code. Now, something important that I need to mention is that when you're uploading your file, there must be at least one index file, actually only one index file, and that file must be there, index.html. Now, index.html is the standard through which a website, when it's called, is, you'd notice that this is cialfuatu.com, but if we did /index.html, it would load the same exact file. And the reason for this is whether you load /index.html or the website itself, it loads to the same file. So it's very important for you to have an index file on your as one of the files that you have. So just in case you had a template and you renamed it to your name.html, you need to change it to index. At least one of them, one of the files should be named to index.html. If there are more than two, that will bring a conflict. So it should only be one file named index.html. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you've learned. If you have any questions for me, feel free to ask me on the comment section below, and I will answer them when I get to that. If you have any other way that you'd like to learn how to upload, you can also post that on the comment section below, and I'd be more than happy to assist. There are other videos that would assist you to do different things, like installing WordPress, which is a website builder. If you don't want to work with code, you can use that instead. And how to set up Outlook, still on this blog. So check that out before you leave, if you need to. So thank you so much, and see you in the next one.